up, guys? It's Kristen Savasapino back here with our sweet neighborhood Spider-Man. And this is Spider-Man Part 2. We saw the first one already. I loved it. I'm hooked. And I want to continue this journey with you. This is a cut-down version of the film because we're only allowed to show you picture within picture. However, if you would like to see the full version of this film, uninterrupted and uncut, all you gotta do is join our Patreon page or become a member of this channel. Keep in mind that you will need a copy of your own video so you can throw it side by side up. And when I give you that 3, 2, 1, boom, bada, bang, easy, easy. And it's like we're in the same room. Now, before we get started, please hit that subscribe button, bell icons, all notifications, and upvote this video. For those of you wondering what happened here, I broke my finger. Long story, we're not gonna get into it. let's just get going.
I'm Spider-Man, given a job to do. And I'm Peter Parker, and I too have a job.
Parker! Parker! No, stop, stop!
Oi!
You have to go 42 blocks in 7.5 minutes, or your ass is fired.
No pressure, dude. No pressure. I'd be like, just fire me. I don't think I could take that pressure. Or I would see it as a challenge, and then I'd be like, all right, let's go. Is that a bet? I couldn't go either way. It just depends on what mood I'm in, I guess. Is he gonna use his power, like his web?
Oh, he stole that guy's pizza!
Oh no.
No playing in the streets.
Yes, Mr. Spider-Man.
See ya.
No, he took a slice. Can't deliver that now. Oh, okay. Still touched his hands. He's just having an off day. I'm having one of those days today.
Pizza time.
Damn.
You're fired. Parker, hello. You're fired.
Why?
Dogs catching frisbees? I pay you because for some reason that psycho Spider-Man will pose for you. Get your pretty little portfolio off my desk before I go into a diabetic coma. Sticks. Robbie, there's your page 1. Masked menace terrorizes town.
What is this guy's deal?
I'll give you 150.
300.
That's outrageous. Mm. Done. Give this to the girl.
Hey, Pete. I don't think this covers the advance I gave you a couple weeks ago.
Right.
Sorry. Hey. Chin up, okay?
Oh, new love interest, maybe?
Oh!
This day just needs to end.
Look at you, Peter. Your grades have been steadily declining. You're late for class.
Oh.
Octavius is a friend of mine. You better do your research, Parker. Get it done, or I'm failing you.
That's nice of him. Was he missing an arm?
What's the occasion?
Oh, really, Peter? It's your birthday. Whether you want to remember it or not.
Long time no see.
So, how's the play? I read a great review.
Just making it.
We're actually funding one of your idols, Pete, Otto Octavius.
I'm writing a paper on him.
You want to meet him?
You'd introduce me?
You bet.
I want us to be friends, Harry. I want us to trust each other.
And be honest with me. If you knew who he was, would you tell me?
No. That'd be so hard to be the person that people are kind of like hating and bashing, knowing you're trying so hard to do the right things and be good.
Here, kiddo, happy birthday. You need it more than I do.
Aw.
Can't take that from
you. Yes, you can. You can take this money from me. For God's sake, it's not much. Now take it.
Oh, that just breaks my heart.
I liked seeing you tonight, Peter.
Oh, boy, yeah.
Oh boy, yeah. Do you want to say something?
Yes, he does.
Was wondering if you're still in the village.
I'm seeing somebody now.
You mean like a boyfriend?
Well, like I like him.
Ooh.
Maybe more than that.
Oh.
More?
I don't know.
Oh, she's playing games with you right now. She's just trying to see if it affects you.
But my job is done here. Got you two geniuses together. Good luck tomorrow, Otto. Nobel Prize.
Interesting fellow, your friend.
Mm-hmm.
Now I remember you. You're Connor's student. Tells me you're brilliant. He also tells me you're lazy.
Damn.
An exponential increase in energy output.
A huge amount of energy. Like a perpetual sun providing renewable power for the whole world.
This is going to be like a life-changing moment.
T.S. Eliot is more complicated than advanced science. But if you want to get a woman to fall in love with you, feed her poetry.
Ha!
Poetry.
Poetry. Well done, sir.
Her hair was like the sunshine. Day by day, he gazed upon her.
That's right. Do your homework. I love it.
Ladies, 5 minutes. 5 minutes.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
How'd you do that?
You know, eat your green vegetables.
That's what my mom is always saying.
That was great. Too cute. Oh.
It's a web.
Go, Spidey, go!
I love how everybody just changed his name. Like, gave him that nickname, Spidey.
Hey, you might wanna...
Come on, dude, stop.
Come to see the show.
Oh, I'm sorry, sir. No one will be seated after the doors are closed.
What are you doing here?
Oh, she wasn't even lying. Oh, your friend gave you wrong information. Hey. Whoa, what just happened?
What was that?
Yeah, what was that? Don't do it. Don't do it.
Cool Spidey outfit.
Thanks.
Looks uncomfortable.
It gets kind of itchy. It rides up in the crotch a little bit, too.
Oh, that'd be so hard. Her face is everywhere, too. I'm happy for her, though. Her life's turning out the way she wanted it to.
Somebody has to talk to the mushroom kid.
Your time has expired. Please deposit 50 cents.
Oh, he's good. Ah!
I want to tell you the truth. I'm Spider-Man. Weird, huh? Now you know why I can't be with you.
That is rough when you want to tell somebody something and you just can't.
These four actuators were developed and programmed for the sole purpose of creating successful fusion. They are impervious to heat and magnetism.
Oh, he's gonna become a bad guy, isn't he? I hope not, but
These smart arms are controlled by my brain through a neural link.
The artificial intelligence in the arms is as advanced as you suggest. Couldn't that make you vulnerable to them?
Which is why I developed this inhibitor chip to protect my higher brain function. It means I maintain control of these arms instead of them controlling me.
I don't like this. I don't like where this is going at all.
Precious tritium is the fuel that makes this project go. There's only 25 pounds of it on the whole planet.
Fasten your seatbelts.
Doctor, we have a successful fusion reaction.
Whew.
The power of the sun in the palm of my hand.
Oh no. Oh, this would be.
Find the plug!
Oh. Oh. Oh! Oh!
Hey,
Of course they have to eliminate the two characters that you absolutely fall in love with right from the get-go. And then they're like, yeah, let's hurt your feelings, you guys. Let's eliminate them.
I'm ruined.
Yeah,
you have nothing left except Spider-Man.
Ton of money.
Anybody here take shop class?
Oh, I don't think it's funny. I think that's rude. Oh, I don't want to watch this. Oh, yo, I didn't have to add that. The scratching on the nails on the floor just like gave me the worst heebie-jeebies. Ugh. Ugh. So it's not really him. It's those things that are connected to him because that chip in his brain got destroyed.
Mad scientist goes berserk and we don't have pictures. Where were you? Photographing squirrels? You're fired.
Chief, the planetarium party.
Oh, right. You're unfired. I need you. Come here. You're all I got.
Big this guy's
party
bipolar.
For an American hero. My son, the astronaut.
But could you pay me in advance?
Are you serious?
My Rosie's dead. My dream is dead. Monstrous thing should be at the bottom of the river, along with me. Oh.
So he's still sane, and like, he's not completely crazy.
I couldn't have miscalculated. It was working, wasn't it? Yes.
We could rebuild. Enlarge the containment field. Make it bigger and stronger than ever.
We need money.
Steal it. No. I'm not a criminal.
The real crime would be not to finish what we started.
Like a mad scientist. I think all scientists are somewhat mad, and you kind of have to be in order to create the impossible.
My Uncle Ben's life insurance.
Yes, but I'm afraid it's just not sufficient to refinance your home.
I'm giving piano lessons again.
You are?
Ow! Oh.
What are the odds of that happening right then?
Peter? Don't leave me.
Oh, that boy of yours is a real hero.
You have no idea.
Oh, no. Come on.
Ha! I want to know what's happening to his spider web. How come it's not working? Is he losing his power? Oh, no.
Easy now.
Butterfingers.
You guys had me. Oh, thank goodness his webs are working right when he needed it, right there.
Oh, thank you. Oh, have I been wrong about you?
We sure showed him.
What do you mean, we?
I wish Aunt May would know. Like, I wish she, like, could hear his voice and be like, that's my boy.
Get a shot of us with the DA.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, here, get a shot of the mayor and his girlfriend.
Oh, no.
Wife.
Ouch. Oh, my. No freaking way.
Beautiful Miss Mary Jane Watson. Just agreed to marry me.
How can you sit there and agree to marry somebody when your heart's still with someone else?
Wake up! Shoot the picture!
Ah, brutal. I I get the part of moving on because the person you want isn't showing up for you. If you're going to marry somebody, you got to just let that go completely and kind of throw it to the side, not have a conversation with the guy. I think it's time to do some spider research. Oh no. You need your glasses again.
All the things you've been thinking about, Peter, make me sad.
Can't you understand? I'm in love with Mary Jane. I want a life of my own.
You've been given a gift, Peter. With great power comes great responsibility. Take my hand, son.
I'm just Peter Parker. I'm Spider-Man. No more.
Definitely did not see that coming.
0.23 electron volts.
Excellent work today, Parker. Keep it up.
Come on.
I always imagine you getting married on a hilltop.
And who's the groom?
You hadn't decided yet. Things get in the way before. There was something I thought I had to do. I don't have to.
You're too late.
Will you think about it?
No.
I'm getting married in a church.
Not on a hill.
I got a garbage man here, so he's got something you might want to see.
Oh.
Abandoned his sad little masquerade. I finally got to him. The power of the press triumphs.
You're an ass. What a butthead. Come on, doesn't that hurt your feelings?
Help!
Come on. He is not gonna walk away. Are you serious? He just walked away? You couldn't even do a simple, like, something? I'm so disappointed right now.
The thief was running towards me. I could have stopped him, but I wanted revenge. Uncle Ben was killed that night for being the only one who did the right thing.
Hello, Harry.
Otto.
What do you want?
Precious tritium.
Kill Spider-Man. I'll give you all the tritium you need. On second thought, bring him to me.
How do I find him?
Peter Parker.
Oh.
I found a small apartment.
Why didn't you tell me?
I'm quite able to take care of things myself. And Henry Jackson across the street is giving me a...
Henry Jackson.
But you made a brave move in telling me the truth. And I'm proud of you. I love you, Peter.
You take Spider-Man's pictures, right?
I used to.
Where is he?
Henry and I agree. We don't see his picture in the paper anymore.
She's gotta know something.
Flying around like that, saving old girls like me. Lord knows, kids like Henry need a hero. Courageous, self-sacrificing people.
She knows. She knows.
And give up the thing we want the most, even our dreams. Spider-Man did that for Henry, and he wonders where he's gone.
His aunt and uncle are just so wise.
Strong focus on what I want.
Here we go again.
I'm back! I'm back!
Oh. Ow. Oh.
Oh. I'm back. My back!
That was just rough. I think it was the excitement. He's like, I'm back!
Maybe rushed into things. I thought...
Wait a minute. What are you saying?
I thought I could be there for you, Mary Jane. But I can't.
Uh-oh.
Ouch. Do you love me or not?
Be honest. Say yes and then say I just can't.
Don't.
Ah!
Kiss me.
Mm-hmm.
Kiss you.
Isn't she still engaged or did she call it off?
Just one kiss.
Nope. Still engaged. And it's back. Oi.
What's happening?
I want you to find your friend, Spider-Man. Tell him to meet me at the West Side Tower at 3 o'clock. Or I'll peel the flesh off her bones.
Take it off. And we're back in business. That was a cool shot.
Spider-Man was a hero. He was a thief! A criminal! He stole my suit!
This guy!
Where is she?
Oh, she'll be just fine. Let's talk.
Oh my gosh. They all saw his face.
Any more bright ideas?
I got a few.
Come on. Superman, when you need him so he can fly and just like push it back.
He's just a kid.
We found something. We won't tell nobody.
What a great moment in this film.
He's mine!
You want to get to him, you got to go through me.
And me.
Very well.
Ah, I love that brave moment from all the regular people. Normally in any other film, like, the masses could win. But not against people who are, like, super crazy powers or of some sort. Uh-oh.
Where do you want him?
Oh, no.
And the tritium?
Oh,
first
no.
First you see who's behind the mask. You can look into your eyes as you die. Peace. No.
He's got MJ.
No. All he wanted was the tritium.
He's making the machine again. When that happens, she'll die along with half of New York.
You killed my father.
There are bigger things happening here than me and you.
Oh my gosh, this is not the time. Tell him what happened. Communication is key. It always bites us in the butt and then people just...
Surprise.
As soon as you get free.
I should have known Osborn wouldn't have the spine to finish you.
Shut it down, Ock. You're gonna hurt a lot more.
Oh. You have a scientist's mind. You're brilliant.
Dr. Octavius.
Oh, he's back.
We have to shut it down. Please tell me how.
Peter Parker. Brilliant, but lazy. I can't destroy it. I won't.
Oh, I thought he snapped to his senses.
You once spoke to me about intelligence. That it was a gift to be used for the good of mankind.
It was my dream.
Sometimes, to do what's right, we have to be steady and give up the thing we want the most.
Oh.
Even our dreams.
Man, that line is so... so good.
He's right. Listen. Listen to me now. The river. Drown it. I'll do it.
He's gonna go be with his wife. Oh my goodness. No way. Oh.
Hi.
Hi.
This is really heavy.
Like, move. Try to move. Get out of there.
In case we die.
You do love me.
I do.
Even though you said you didn't.
Duh. He's trying to protect you. Come on, move. What'd you hook onto, though, when you jumped up from there? Oh, okay. Thank you. I needed to see where we went to for my own mental health.
I think I always knew all this time who you really were.
And you know why we can't be together. Spider-Man will always have enemies. You and I can never be.
Watching her run to another lover's arms. Ugh. Oh no, we're not done here. I forgot about him for a second. I don't know how that happened, but there's a lot going on and I forgot about him. Oh no, the mask is going to talk to him now. The outfit.
Who's that?
Son.
What?
I'm here.
Now you know the truth about Peter. Avenge me.
Avenge me!
No!
Oh. Ah! It looks like we got some choices to make there.
Peter.
Oh no.
Mary Jane.
I can't survive without you. I know there'll be risks, but I want to face them with you. So here I am, standing in your doorway. Go get him, Tiger.
All right, where do I even start? Wow, that's a lot to take in, you guys. I loved Dr. Ock. I really did. I loved him and his wife. I loved when he said, I'm not gonna go down, you know, as a bad guy. I love that line. This one had like a lot of life lessons that were really good and a lot of uplifting and inspirational moments that I really enjoyed. I love that, you know, in this one, Spider-Man, he's completely lost and he doesn't know who he is or what he wants to be. He's so confused and so all over the place to the point where he, you know, he's losing his ability to be him, Spider-Man. And it's interesting how he finally gives it up to go back to like a normal human being. And that's kind of hard. I feel like to go from something that people look up to, you know, I mean, just being that in general is hard enough, but to leave and then watch crime happened right in front of you, that's even harder. It's interesting because throughout this journey, he's going out of his way. He's trying really hard to do the best for the better good, and he just keeps getting trashed. He keeps getting demolished, and like people are just hating. And that's really hard. Like, I think anyone, like on a regular level, if you're constantly getting told that you're bad and you suck and all this stuff, you have like rumors going around and lies being told about you. Sometimes it is hard to remember why you're doing what you're doing. And sometimes it's hard to remember who you are, because when you hear a lie so much, you tend to start to believe that, especially when you're hitting, like you're batting zero nonstop, like again, again, and again. Eventually you're gonna sit there and be like, maybe I do suck. Maybe I am like, and then you sit there, you know, and you're like, you remember, you're like, no, I'm actually not that bad. And then you're like, you know, people suck. And then you go through this whole thing. It's a normal thing to feel unappreciated and like crap because you're not getting, you know, that support that you need. And I feel like for Spider-Man, like he's been living this lonely life. And it's interesting because this time is the first time, you know, we have some people who've seen his face and they're willing to keep it a secret. And I love the train when they all caught him. And it's the first time that people are giving back to try and to attempt to help him versus him always constantly giving. And they just take, you know, he's actually receiving on the other end and seeing how much he inspires others and how much he's made a difference for those of all ages. It's not just the youth, but the elderly as well. And that's pretty cool. Harry, his best friend, I love the fact that he was like, he's my best friend, no, and he finally like stands up to his dad and like kind of puts his foot down. But then the moment he walks through the broken glass to that separate room has me worried. And I want him to be enemies because you can tell like he really authentically loves his friend and like they both care about each other deeply. And I want him to get the full story. Like, okay, that goes back to like the communication, right? Communication is key. If you don't open your mouth and express things to people and tell them what you need to say, how are they going to know? And I get sometimes like we want to keep silent for certain reasons, or they don't want to make things worse, or they hide it because they're afraid they're going to hurt your feelings or you're going to hate them or whatever. But a lot of the times with communication, like good solid communication, comes understanding and comprehension. So I do struggle with that in this film, but I get it. The moment with Ben Parker killed me. He's sitting there giving him all this amazing advice and says, take my hand. And you know he Peter Parker wants to take that. You know he wants to take his hand. And he's just like, no, I'm going to be rebellious. And like, I just don't want this burden anymore. And it's like, that's what he grew up with. He grew up with those morals. He grew up with that backbone of doing the right thing. And I love how Aunt May, she's in need of money. The money's flying everywhere. She easily could have pickpocketed like a few of those things. And then the banker starts to grab one and she's like, no. Like, wow. I love the family. I love the friendships. But this is something I'm going to bring up too, because I was thinking about it before I lose my train of thought. It's interesting because Mary Jane, she comes from the same side of the woods as Peter Parker, right? They're neighbors. And her life was pretty rough. And it's interesting how both films, she goes for the guy who's very well off, right? And I sit there and I'm like, all right, I get it. Like, you come from nothing. You want to be something. You want to whatever. She wants Peter Parker, who isn't that established yet, you know? He's still working his way through the world and stuff like that. And then next thing you know, she can't have him. So she goes and gets another guy that's even higher than the last guy. You know, and it's just like an interesting thing. And then she goes back to Peter Parker, which is pretty cool, you know? Because like, it's like, okay, yes, I feel like if you're going to settle, I feel like in her mind, she's like, if I'm going to settle, I'm going to settle for like the top. I don't know, maybe I'm wrong. But in reality, she doesn't care about all that stuff. She just wants Peter Parker. But if she's going to settle, she's like, all right, if I'm going to settle, I'm going to go high. I do get a little bit frustrated with the storyline of him being the pizza man and like struggling and all this stuff. And I know that adds to his character. And I understand like, okay, he's so busy, because I was thinking about it. I'm like, how is he not able to get a better job? Because I'm like, he's so smart. He can do so many things. But then I'm like, okay. But he doesn't have the time to even focus on any of that. And I think this was kind of cool how they showed that. But he's taking care of so many other people before himself. And I love that all of a sudden Dr. Ox gives him that line, you know, about knowledge and like how that's power and like you're supposed to use it for the greater good and all this stuff, and including the professor, you know. I love that they sit there and they give that reminder of, hey, you're brilliant. Like, that's the only place where he I feel like in this film, he wasn't failing. Because through the whole thing, he was just like kind of failing, stumbling, rough. And then it comes to, hey, let me remind you how brilliant and smart and capable you are of so much more. But the fact that he takes it to another level of he's also Spider-Man, like gives him another, you know, that gives him another notch up, because you're kind of like, all right, I don't suck. My first language is not English, is my third, okay? So with that being said, this just kind of gives me this background where I remember kids used to make fun of me and they're like, oh, you're dumb, you're this, oh, you're an ESL. And it just took me back to that moment because I was bullied so severely with that because I couldn't read or write. And I'm like already in high school. And it got to the point where I finally tested out of ESL and these children who had one language. And meanwhile, I had three. And I remember sitting there finally thinking one day as they were calling me out, I was like, you know, they called me dumb again and all this stuff. And I just remember stopping because I had just tested out. And I remember it was the first time I was able to comprehend and deliver a message with confidence. And I remember just looking at them saying, you know, my first language is German. My second is Japanese. English is my third. I read and write Japanese fluently. I just tested out of your native tongue, your native language, that you, and you had one job. I sat there and I came here and I've learned your language. And now I read and write it and speak it. Sometimes it's a little rough, but at least I can do that. And I tested out, you're still in that same class I'm in. So who's really dumb, me or you? In that moment, it had me kind of go, whoa, okay, Kristen, like you're not dumb. You have obstacles because of X, Y, Z. You know what I mean? So I feel like there's always like more to the stories. And I like that it gave me that kind of vibe. I think you guys can follow with what I'm saying. It really did. This was lovable. I'm not sure if I like this one or the first one. I think I like the first one still better than two, but I do like where this is going, because I feel like now we're building a bigger story And this was just, I feel like this is just the beginning of it. Now I feel like so many questions are answered, but also he's becoming him. And now we're going more into depth, you know, with what he believes and what he stands for and how he's going to stay true to his roots and where he came from and who brought him up and all that good stuff. I really liked it, you guys. You let me know in the comment zone what you think of the film. If I missed anything, please fill me in. If you'd like to continue this with me, put it in the comment zone, and I'd really appreciate that. Anyways, you guys, I'm Chris Sepsipino. Thank you guys for joining me. Before I get off, could you please hit the subscribe button, bell icons, all notifications, and upvote this video. Really appreciate it, and thanks for watching this with me. I'm Chris Sepsipino. See you next time. Bye.